हाय गाइस, आई एम समंदर सिंह फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, आर्य कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, कुकस, जयपुर। टुडेज टॉपिक इज एक्सेल फ्लो कंप्रेसर, सब्जेक्ट टर्बो मशीनरी। एक्सेल फ्लो कंप्रेसर, वी डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन एंड वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ एक्सेल फ्लो कंप्रेसर, वर्क डन फैक्टर, डिग्री ऑफ रिएक्शन, एलिमेंट्री थ्योरी, वर्टेक्स थ्योरी एंड कंप्रेसिबिलिटी इफेक्ट एंड कैस्केड टेस्ट ऑन एक्सेल फ्लो कंप्रेसर। नाउ एक्सेल फ्लो कंप्रेसर, इट इज ए सेक्शनल व्यू ऑफ द एक्सेल फ्लो कंप्रेसर विच कंटेंट्स इनलेट केसिंग एट लेफ्ट हैंड साइड एंड राइट हैंड साइड अटैच द आउटलेट फॉलोइंग द स्टेशनरी ब्लेड कैरियर ऑन विच स्टेशनरी ब्लेड्स आर माउंटेड। एट द सेंटर वी हैव द शाफ्ट हैविंग द इम्पेल माउंटेड द इम्पेलर। On the shaft or impeller, we have the rotor blades. The combination of stator blade and rotor blade is called stage. The working principle of axial flow compressor. As in axial flow compressor, the working fluid enters and leaves the compressor in axial direction. It is a rotating airfoil based compressor in which the working fluid principally flow parallel to the axis of rotation. In axial flow compressor, the kinetic energy is transmitted to the air by rotating the blades, which is then converted into the pressure rise. The compressor is made up of number of such stages to give an overall pressure ratio from inlet to outlet. The air enters axially from right into the inlet guide vane, from where it is deflected by a certain angle to impinge on the first row of the rotating blades with the proper angle of attack. The kinetic energy is added to the air by rotating blades. Due to this, there is a slight pressure rise into the air. The air is discharged at a proper angle to the first row of the stator blades, where pressure is further increased by the diffusion. The air is directed to the second row of moving blades. Then same process is repeated for remaining stages, and finally the pressure rise pressure increases from stage to stage. Now, as the fluid moves from stage to stage, the height of the blade decreases, so the constant axial velocity, that is CA1 equal to CA2 equal to CA3 equal to CA, remains the constant, where 1 is for at inlet and 2 at the outlet of the rotor blades, CA3 the inlet to the stator blades, or CA that is the axial velocity. The axial velocity is maintained through the compressor as the density increases from the stage to stage. We can say the continuity equation rho A V, that is rho 1 A1 CA1 equal to rho 2 A2 CA2. Mass flow rate remains constant as first stage and second stage, that having the finally rho 1 H1 equal to rho 2 H2. Now velocity triangle. In velocity triangle, we have the three velocity triangle, that is at inlet velocity triangle, that is figure A, outlet velocity triangle figure B, and velocity triangle C, that is the combination of inlet and outlet velocity triangle. In inlet velocity triangle, we have the velocities of the air, that is C1, absolute velocity of air CA1, absolute axial velocity of the air with respect to blade tip, and flow velocity of air W1 with tip blade angle beta 1, and absolute velocity having the alpha 1 blade angle to the blade. Now at exit velocity, we have the C2, CA2 and W2, while WX1 is the एक्सियल कंपोनेंट ऑफ द फ्लो वेलोसिटी और वर्ल कंपोनेंट एट इनलेट दैट इज डब्ल्यू एक्स वन एट आउटर दैट इज डब्ल्यू एक्स टू एंड यू इज द इम्पेलर टिप वेलोसिटी दैट इज आर पी एम इन टर्म्स ऑफ आर पी एम दैट मीन्स द कॉन्स्टेंट एट फिगर थ्री वी हैव द फिगर सी वी हैव द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ इनलेट एंड वेलोसिटी ट्रायंगल एंड आउटर वेलोसिटी ट्रायंगल From the velocity triangle, we have the at entry we have C A one equal to C one sine alpha one equal to W one C sine beta one C W one equal to C one cos alpha one equal to C A one cot beta one C X one equal to W one cos beta one equal to C A one cot beta one U equal to W X two plus W C W two. That we have the C A two C A one cot beta alpha one plus C W one cos beta one equal to C A one cot alpha one plus C A one cot beta one, and we have the C A one cot alpha one plus cot beta one is the equation number five. At velocity we have C A two equal to C two sine alpha two equal to W two sine beta two. By using the simple mathematical relations from the velocity triangle, we have these number of equations that are used. Now from equation 1 and 6 we have the equation C theta sine alpha 1 equal to W 1 sine beta 1 equal to C 2 sine beta 1 equal to C 2 sine alpha 2 equal to W 1 sine beta 2. Equation 5 and 10 we have flow coefficient phi equal to U upon C A that is in terms of phi equal to cot alpha 1 plus cot beta 1 cot or we can say cot alpha 2 plus cot beta 2. From equation 9 and 10 we have the relation W U1 plus C W1 equal to W U2 plus C W2 or finally we can get C A1 cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2 equal to C A2 cot alpha 2 minus cot alpha 1 while the C A1 equal to C A2. From equation 13 14 we have C W2 minus C W1 equal to C A1 cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2 or this equal to cot alpha 2 equal into cot CA2 into cot alpha 2 minus cot alpha 1. Now the stage work or energy transfer. The energy given to the air per unit mass flow rate is given by Euler equations. Mathematically W by M equal to CW2 U2 minus CW1 U1 and E energy equal to that is per unit CW2 U2 minus CW1 U1 upon G. From velocity triangle, CA is the constant throughout the stage. U remains the constant U equal to U1 equal to U2. And CW2 equal to U2 U equal to CA. CW1 equal to U equal to CA. And we have the energy equation. U into CW2 minus CW1 upon G equal to CA. U into cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2 upon G. Or similarly the in terms of absolute velocity flow angle the energy transfer equation can be written as E equal to U C A U into cot alpha 2 minus cot alpha 1 upon G. The work done factor. Work done. First we discuss the work done, next we define the work done factor. Work done that is can be obtained by W equal to CW2 minus U2 minus CW1 U1 upon G that is joule per kg and we get the by mathematical lessons UCA cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2 upon GC that is joule per kg. Now, overall pressure ratio per stage. The energy input to the axial flow compressor will be absorbed in increasing the pressure and velocity of the fluid and this energy will be used in overcoming the various friction losses. Now the overall pressure ratio per stage can be obtained by using the different formula using the overall isentropic efficiency of the compressor that is defined as the ideal isentropic work input upon actual work input. Overall efficiency that is equal to H0
3 minus H02 over H03 minus H01 and can be obtained as T01 into T01 upon T01 T03 upon T01 minus T1 upon T03 minus T01. And further, the equation can be written as in terms of pressure ratio P03 upon P01 equal to T03 minus T01 upon T01 plus 1 key power gamma upon R minus R upon R minus 1 or gamma upon gamma minus 1. That is the gas constant, adiabatic gas constant. The further, the equations can be written in terms of pressure ratio, and finally we have the work done equal to delta H naught equal to H02 minus H01 equal to H03 minus H01. That it can be Cp obtained as Cp T02 minus T01 equal to Cp T03 minus T01. That is Cp delta T0. And for the equation can be obtained as, now work done factor. It is defined as the actual work absorbing capacity upon idle work absorbing capacity of the compressor. As in previous equation, we had the W equal to phi U Cw2 minus Cw1 upon Gc. And further, we have the T02 minus T01 equal to T03 minus T01 equal to psi UCa into cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2 upon Gc into Cp. The stage loading of pressure coefficient. The stage loading is defined as the ratio of work input to the term MC mu square. It is denoted by the psi p. Work input upon mu square. Psi p equal to psi u into Cw2 minus Cw1 upon u square. And further, we have the psi into Cw2 minus Cw1 upon u. And psi p equal to psi into phi cot alpha 2 minus cot alpha 1 can be obtained. Degree of reaction. The degree of reaction is defined as the enthalpy rise due to the change of the static pressure in the rotor to total enthalpy rise in the stage. The degree of reaction is denoted by the R. R equal to H2 minus H1 upon H3 minus H1. Then H2 minus H1 equal to W1 square minus W2 square upon 2. As the C1 equal to C3. Then the H3 minus H1 equal to H03 minus H01 equal to 4 into Cw2 minus Cw1. Putting these values of the H2 minus H1 and H3 minus H1 in equation 1, we have the omega W1 square minus W2 square upon 24 C W2 minus Cw1.
The degree of reaction is a useful concept in compressor design, and it is possible to produce a formula for it in terms of the various velocities and air angles associated with the stage. It provides an exact extent to which the rotor contributes to overall static pressure rise in the stage. Elementary theory. Generally, air is used as working fluid in an axial flow compressor by applying the steady flow energy equation to the rotor and assuming the adiabatic process. Power input can be given W equal to MCP into T01 minus T02, and repeating the process with the stator, where the process can be assumed adiabatic and zero work input, that is T02 equal to T03. The air approaches the rotor with a velocity C1 at angle alpha 1 from the axial direction. The vectorial combination of velocity C1 with the blade speed U gives the velocity relative to the blade W1 at angle beta 1. The power is absorbed in the rotor, and the stator merely transform the kinetic energy to increase the in static pressure with stationary stagnation temperature. The absolute velocity of the rotor is increased by passing through the rotor, and the fluid leaves the rotor with a relative velocity c2 at angle beta 2. Let the design is such that the axial velocity ca is kept constant. Value of w2 can be determined, and outward velocity angle constructed by combining the w2 and u vectorly gives the c2 at angle alpha 2. Now, assuming that the CA1 equal to CA2 equal to CA, two basic equations follow the immediately from the geometry of the velocity triangle. This area includes the UA upon CA, U upon CA equal to cot alpha 1 plus cot beta 1. That is equal to again the cot alpha 2 plus cot beta 2. Considering the change in the angular momentum of the air is passing through the rotor, the following equations for the power input can be included: W equal to M into U CW2 minus CW1. It is more useful to express the power in terms of rotor blades at angle beta 1 and beta 2. Thus, we have that W equal to MU CW2 minus CW1, or MU into CA into cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2, as C cot alpha 2 minus cot alpha 1 equal to cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2. The input energy will be absorbably useful in the raising the pressure of air, and wastefully whole of this input will reveal itself as a rise in the stagnation temperature of the air, that is W equal to MC into T02 minus T01. But the W equal to MC MUCA cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2 MCP T02 minus T01 equal to MC MUCA cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2. By using the or simplifying these equation, we have delta T0 equal to T01 minus T02 equal to 4 CA upon CP cot beta 1 minus cot beta 2. The pressure rise obtained will be strongly dependent on the efficiency of the compression process. Let the isentropic efficiency is neta I equal to T03 dash minus T01 upon T03 minus T01. The stage pressure is given by PR, that is P02 upon P01 equal to 1 plus neta delta T01 upon T01 power R upon R minus 1. To obtain high temperature rise in a stage which is desirable to minimize the number of stages for a given overall pressure ratio, the design must combine the high blade speed, high axial velocity and high fluid deflection, that is beta 1 minus beta 2 in rotor blades. Now thank you.